So, alright guys, in this video tutorial you are going to learn how to fold the Tsuru Kawasaki Rose Crane by Satoshi Kamiya. I'm going to start off with a square sheet of paper. I'm going to fold it diagonally. Turn over. Fold it in half. So now basically just like the preliminary base. Fold just right like that. And right like that. This head should look like. You want to keep it in half. You're now going to lift the edge up and you're going to connect this corner with this corner. You're not going to fully crease, you just want to go up here and go down there. And then you want to mark in the middle. So now what you've basically done is you've created a mark just about here. You're now going to take the edge and fold it to that mark you've created. Turn over and you're going to now fold edge to edge. So you want to basically now align the new crease you made with the upper edge. So that you get something that looks like this. Open up and repeat these steps. Open up. Now you should basically have these center lines in the middle. Now you're going to take paper, fold it diagonally, and fold that in half again. Now you're going to fold the top to that crease you made. I'm just going to zoom in a little for this. So you're going to fold that tip to the edge right here. And you want to be creasing tightly. This is good. First of all, going to be a reference and later on it will be the center of the rose. Like this. I'm going to open it up. So now you should have a square within a square within a square. Just going to mark this for you. See that. So now, what you're in the next step are going to be doing is you're going to go from that center square and you want to be connecting that edge with that edge. And you're going to do so with each of the other ones. So now I'm just going to zoom out a little because this is getting out of focus. However, you know what you're basically going to do is connect that edge with that edge. That edge with that edge. So you should then rearrange that. Have something that looks like this. So now I'm just going to do that. You're taking paper. That's... So just about red, like a windmill sort of. Now we're going to take the paper and turn it around. You've got a square at the back as well. And you're now going to be connecting that edge with that edge in a diagonal manner. Just like this. This. Just for you to see the scheme. So you're going to connect that lower edge with that edge. Right. Now, I'm going to do this. Alright, so just like this. What you're then going to be doing is you want to recrease the creases you made previously. So what you're going to basically be doing is this. So that you basically now create the base of that rose-like shape that you want to achieve. Now going to turn over, and it's going to be helpful to do that. You're going to be taking that edge right here and align it with that edge right there. Then make sure that this goes in. You're going to pull up right here. So like this, and repeat that on all of the other sides just as well. So like this, like this, and the last one will probably form by itself. And so you now should have, when you align these edges with each other, and when you just squish that a little, you should get that rose-like shape in the center. From the bottom, it looks just like this. And then you're going to be folding it into the preliminary base. So just push from all of the sides. And that's right. You're going to be having it just like this. The rose is going to be on top. And it should look like this. From now on, it's basically the petal fold. But I'm going to make a little variation on this, because I think you can do this much more precisely when you crease that from the inside. So you don't want to crease it like that, but you're going to go right here, and you just pre-crease in the middle to the center line, and you pre-crease that, and just like this to the center line, just like this. The center line, and just repeat that all the way around. Right. Okay. you want to close that model again. You see if pre-crease at all, and you want to now get to your previous shape again. So actually taking it again like this. Now you're going to be doing the pedal fold. So you lift that up and one pedal. Other pedal like this, turn around, and you're going to be doing this part here as well, just like this, and like this. So now that's what it should look like now. Now you're going to lift this up for the wings, just right like this. Make sure that the crease you make this tightly. Take it. You get to lift that up. Now just right. Alright. So that's how it should look like. What you're now going to do is halfen these again. You go up to the top, and when you come right here, you want to be creasing that tightly all the way up, even right to that point. Do that on the other sides, just like this as well. This one is probably going to become a bit more complicated because you have got that additional flap right here, but you just want to make sure that you fold that in just as well. Now take the paper, turn it around, and repeat this right here. And repeat this right here. And then finally, you're going to do this right here, just as well. Like this. The rose is in the center, and now this is going to be the hardest part of the model actually. You want to make sure that you don't destroy that entire shape, but you now want to lift that up and you're going to fold up, just right like you do it with a crane, with a normal crane. This is going to be harder. And don't crease so tightly, just first of all, repeat that on the other side just as well. It gets easier when you use both hands to do it. Alright. This is a view from below. You want to just make sure that these are nice and tight as well. And refine that a little, because this is probably going to be a bit crumply. And then you're just going to do a slight reverse fold for the head. Now see, my rose is a bit squish, but you can quite easily get that shape its normal extents again. So just take a tweezer and just want to arrange that slightly. Alright, and then you're going to just, don't need a tweezer for this, you can just wrap this around a pen or something, and you just want to shape the wings a little. Shape that wing as well. And there you have it. The Tsuru Rose Crane. A beautiful model.